Good morning and welcome to AM Arkansas. We're so glad that you've decided to join us this morning. I'm Tina.
I'm Molly.
I'm Adam.
Sorry. He's Adam.
It's hard to remember. Sometimes.
And I'm Zach.
Right.
They're just so polite. They're going to wait for the other two.
I figured we'd take turns.
Right. You know how it is.
I wanted to let you take the lead.
And they really expect me to go to class at this hour. Sometimes.
Yeah. I'm not operational. I'm actually asleep.
Clearly. No. So... Well, today our topic is holistic fitness.
Which I don't even know what that means.
Yeah, I really, before we started, I said, what is holistic fitness?
So what is holistic fitness?
Holistic fitness is fitness, but holistic. Like, you take the whole person, like physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual.
Right. Wow, yeah. I'm impressed you remember all four of the
That was pretty good. Did you?
That was nice.
Have you been repeating that since you got up this
morning? Yeah, physical, mental, I'm impressed.
Yeah, right, I know. Right. See, not even on the front.
So it's
like an acronym, PMES, that's how I remember.
So it's your total...
Right, the word pumice.
Exactly.
Wonderful.
Because, you know, like, a lot of people will just, you know, just exercise their body, but then they'll go, like a mental life. I'm sure there are people like that, like me. And so then a lot of other people just
You only exercise your mental life, or you only exercise your body?
Well,
can't you tell? Obviously, he only exercises his body.
I was going to say, either one is obvious.
With that body, he doesn't have time to exercise his body.
I'm so busy pumping weights in the gym and shooting myself with the syringes. And I just don't have time for...
We do not condone steroids.
So we're going to be talking about overall health, everybody, your whole body health.
But there's a particular reason that we're talking about this today. You might say, you guys are getting a little redundant. You've talked about sleep, you've talked about exercise. I'm pretty sure we've talked about
exercise at some point. Our two repeat viewers are really concerned.
Yeah, you guys are repeating things.
No, but there's a new twist to this. There's a time hook and angle. We are a month away from spring break. So, we're calling this holistic fitness, but really this is, if you don't get your button gear, you're not going to be looking very good on the beach.
This is an
Is this really all about bikinis? Is that what this boils down to?
That's really the theme. But I am getting my wisdom teeth out on spring break. So, when I realized that, I lost all interest in this theme. I thought, I don't care what I look like physically anymore, because I'm going to be laid in bed. In bed with gigantic cheeks. So then Adam very graciously agreed to brainstorm with me as to how we could tweak this and decided, well, you know what? There's more to fitness than your body.
There is. You can lay there and really get,
you know. I will come back and
crosswords,
run
mine. Crosswords, Sudoku.
Well, I'll have nice, healthy hands and Tina will have bloated cheeks. And
yes, but also a bloated mind.
Her mind's going to be ripped, guys. Yeah.
It's going to be blown.
Yeah, all right. No, that sounds wrong, actually. All right. Well, anyway, so what are some, we'll just start with the first one. What are some tips for physical fitness that you all have?
You're asking us?
Yes.
Well, I actually, just on a personal level, tips for physical fitness.
What do we do?
Is physical
fitness. I wake up in the morning and I eat a big breakfast.
Oh, so do I.
And it really, really helps. Tina has her Pop-Tarts.
Oh, that's a huge breakfast.
So healthy.
Tina. Watch out.
I know Zach had his McDonald's this morning.
Very healthy.
Yes.
It's difficult to, like, when I'm in bed, like, this is honest, like, in bed, I'll be planning to eat breakfast, but then when you're actually there, you say, do I want to sleep 10 extra minutes or eat breakfast? And sleep always wins.
Mm-hmm. Well, sleep time always wins.
So how do I counter that?
Go ahead. Well, I was going to say, it doesn't always have to win. If you have a really good reason to get out of bed, like AM Arkansas.
That's true.
Then you should, you'd be rolling, you know, you're just popping out of bed, you're so excited.
Let's just pretend
then you have plenty of extra time.
And you'll be at the studio by like 7.
Well, I was going to say, realistically, a great suggestion would be have stuff you can eat on the go. I know Pop-Tarts are great.
Oh gosh, Pop-Tarts are not a healthy option, but Fiber One bars are. And the only reason I look forward to Fridays because of my Pop-Tarts, because I'm like, you know what? I have to get up super early, and I don't like getting up early,
Fridays,
so I'm
going
to treat myself to Pop-Tarts.
Right, or, you know, grab a granola bar, grab an apple.
Right. Those are great options.
I can do that.
Or just a quick little yogurt. Just eat it and
run. I can do a yogurt, yeah.
So I know at least for me, I wake up in the morning, and the first thing I try to put in my body is fresh fruit and granola and just healthy stuff to get, because you feel better when you do eat healthy, at least for me.
So. Molly, I think I can tell that you eat well, because I feel like she just has a glow about her all the time. Tina. No, I'm really serious. I really mean that. And her eyes are bright. That's how you can tell somebody is healthy, if their eyes are bright.
How healthy am I?
I don't know how that works. Like the.
I've never heard that.
Adam is bursting with health.
Yes.
Health.
Literally.
He's bright-eyed and bushy-tailed this morning. Yes.
With you,
I've never heard the bright eyes.
It's actually the cocaine.
You know, that's just my own personal philosophy. Okay, I don't have any scientific basis for that, but I just feel like when you see someone and their eyes are just sparkling, you know that they've gotten enough sleep, that they're eating.
Yeah, maybe we should Wikipedia that and see if it's real.
Or we could just write it on Wikipedia and then everyone will think
it's
real.
Yeah, I always thought it just meant that we had giant light shining at us.
Speaking of Wikipedia, let's talk about some
mental
exercises.
Nice segue.
You mentioned a couple.
Yeah, you boys probably know more than I do.
Crosswords. Yeah, that was nice.
Oh, the Sudoku. That's a big one right now.
Those are
it's been
too
for
hard.
A few years, but it really does.
Sudoku,
I
tried it like once, and I'm not going to lie. I just couldn't get into it.
Yeah.
Really? Yeah. Well, 25 things you did not know about my mom. One of those is that she is addicted to Sudoku.
Wow.
That's not a bad thing.
So,
yeah, she loves
so is my
it.
Mother. That's a motherly game.
I think maybe it is one of those things where it's like, ooh, we're starting to fear Alzheimer's. And I know that's terrible.
Like the brain age.
I'm serious. I think like you get a little older and you know, I'm not saying that in a bad way. I just think that you get a little older and you start thinking, I need to keep my brain sharp because I'm facing old age.
Yeah.
Well, not my mom particularly.
Like when you get up to, you know, like your late 20s or early 30s, your brain really starts to go.
Right.
Adam and I actually have a special technique for exercising our minds.
Right.
Oh, no, really?
We just lift dictionaries.
Yeah, we lift dictionaries and we
look how smart
have
we
telepathic battles.
That explains why they're
They are very smart.
Mm-hmm.
And they stare into each other's eyes, exchanging information.
Yeah. It doesn't really translate
well,
to television.
Sorry, I'm sorry that you guys got left out of that.
You can't put a microphone in our minds.
So clearly we are long-winded because we are just to the mental category and we were supposed to kind of hit on all four highlights before our first break, but you know, we want to give you guys a chance to kind of recharge.
It's like Lost. You don't know what's
going
to happen.
Don't worry, because coming up we do have a few tips for your overall health and fitness, so we'll have more.
So stay tuned.
Good morning.
Good morning. Every morning there's a halo. Then the morning comes early in the morning. We wake up in the morning when the day is new. Pure morning, pure.
Thanks for sticking around through the break, and thanks for coming back to join us again.
So we're here talking about holistic fitness.
We got the first two down.
Right? Yes, we've already discussed physical fitness, mental fitness, but we're going to go back to physical fitness because
I've already forgotten what the other two are.
We're a little daunted by the emotional and spiritual,
areas. Fitness. Emotional fitness.
Because how who are we to give emotional and spiritual
I just read
fitness?
Twilight over and over again.
I think the more that you cry, the more emotionally fit you are.
I always feel good
after
a good cry.
You know what? No! I was going to say, that is right. And guys are always, you know, they get so upset when girls cry. But I went to a stress seminar. I did, because obviously I'm very stressed out.
I keep hearing about this.
I went, and she was so, the lady was so wonderful. Her name was Danette Heckathorn. We should get her on the show sometime to interview her because she is so nice and she knows so much about stress, which is a relevant topic to kids. But she said that crying really, literally is a good stress reliever, as in like a sane, healthy option. It's not indicative of something wrong with you if you cry every day.
There's a lot worse
Every day.
Wow.
I'm serious, you
just
could cry
constantly
every single day.
Every time you're alone.
I'm not talking about a depressed cry, but I'm talking about like if you are stressed and the stress manifests itself in tears,
that's how you get it out.
That's fine.
But not every day.
But you know, I'm not saying literally every single day, but I'm saying if you cry with regularity, it's okay.
Well, thanks, Tina.
2 p.m., my cry time.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Be like, I'm really sorry. I can't stay after class. I have to go cry.
Well, no. I mean, there are so many days.
It's Weeping Wednesday.
There are so many days I just feel overwhelmed, and there's nothing you can do to release that. I mean, sure, you go work out, you try to get it out. But
well, you
sometimes,
go work out.
Sometimes
I never make it.
Something just triggers a good cry, and after that, I'm like, okay, I'll start over. I feel fresh. So,
for men, I guess our equivalent would be like punching a wall.
I think boys would benefit.
Or kicking a nerd in the face.
I do too. Boys have this fragile side. They're always so
they're hiding.
So scared to reveal. And I think if they cried a little bit, they might be a little
I mean, like, look at Clint Eastwood. He cries all the time. And he's so successful.
And he's Clint Eastwood.
So, but like I said, we're going to go back to physical fitness because, you know, we've discussed emotional fitness now a little bit about crying, but we want to go back to physical because that's really concrete.
Yeah.
And we wanted to talk a little bit about the hyper.
Hyper. But what does the hyper stand for?
My guess
no
would
idea.
Be
I have no
health,
idea.
Program, education, and recreation.
Wow.
That could be right.
Just guessing. I don't know though. During the break, Adam was saying something about like health programming, like health programs, education, rickshaw.
Rickshaw.
Because every time I'm done there, I need a rickshaw to carry me back up that hill. Yeah.
And there is one too.
Really?
There's a rickshaw, which is another
reason why I've been getting people that were walking in the rickshaw. Really? I've just been getting the frat boys to carry me.
At the base of Pomfret, we're gonna have a package on that sometime.
Summoning the mountain.
Well, we don't know what the Hyper stands for, but we know that it has so and offers so many programs for students, faculty, staff. It's for overall health. They have yoga, the Pilates, the hardcore bicycle.
They probably
classes,
have
everything.
Counselors there too if you need it.
Or I know
not,
that the Pat
perhaps.
Walker Health Center definitely has. Counselors.
But don't just walk in.
Don't want
to. If you need help, just walk in.
Tina has a list of some of the events that the Hyper is hosting coming up.
I'm fixating right now on.
Let's all pick one.
I'm fixating. Jeez. On February 26th. Massage techniques.
I gave up massages for Lent, so I won't be able to.
No. You don't get the massage. You go to learn massage techniques so you can give massages.
Oh,
so I really strongly suggest that you go.
So on his next date.
And I really strongly suggest that Drew, my boyfriend, goes. Anyone who would feel.
Let's not bring up Drew this episode. We gave him a hard enough time last time.
I know. Anyone who would feel comfortable giving me a massage, please go on February 26th.
Yeah.
I guarantee you.
I think Dan should go.
I was about to say, Dan.
There we go.
Dan gets so excited.
Dan, of course, is our station manager, and he's in the back helping out.
If the screen goes black for a little bit,
go to this massage class.
He's the one who's bleeping
February 26th. That way, when you're putting our mics on, you can.
Yeah.
You give a little massage.
That's exactly what I want.
We're saying this because Dan is so conscientious about making sure that we're comfortable as we're putting our mics on, and he said, you know, some people are politically correct about it. Some people are weirded out by me touching their hair, he says. So he doesn't even touch our hair. He doesn't do, you know, like, he basically just tells us.
That sounds so bad. Some people are weirded out when I personally touch their heads.
So
anyway,
so there's a lot. They've got things like kayak practice and cave mammothing, whatever that is.
What do you mean kayak practice?
Caving mammoth. What is that?
I don't know.
Like, do you actually go out on a kayak? You just kind of practice? Like a simulation?
Yeah, exactly. It's a kayak simulation.
That's on their backs?
That's what I would think.
I was in like a space shuttle simulation once. Is it sort of like that?
But I think we should. I think that you guys should go to that, and maybe we should go to the caving mammoth to find out what that is.
Yeah, I don't know what that is. It sounds like fun. Mammoths. Mammoths.
Okay. I do like mammoths.
So anyway, all of these things again to sort of prep for spring break, and
is it all coming back to the bikini body? Is it all coming back to the bikini?
For other people, not for me. I'm gonna be in bed. I already said that.
We wanted to find out what your spring break plans are. So Zach and I decided to do a piece of investigative journalism. So here is what we found out.
All right, we are here at Gregson Hall, and we're going to find out what students are doing for spring break. And because people don't like to talk to UAV TV, here we are. All right, we have chocolates. So what are your spring break plans?
Well, right now I'm not sure. I might actually be here, which would be really unfortunate, doing work for a design project, which wouldn't be so fun. But I'd better go on home. You know. Is that good enough?
Good enough for a chocolate.
Yay! Oh, goodness. Thank you.
So, Jenny, what are you doing for spring break?
Probably not much. Actually, I'm going with a few friends for, I think, the beginning of the weekend, up to Caddo River.
You may have a chocolate.
Thank you.
I'm just going home. Nothing exciting to report.
Good enough.
What is it?
It's not flavored.
Nice.
It's dragon flavored. So, what are you doing for spring break?
I really don't know yet.
No idea?
Not be going home, not be going to Florida.
All right. Florida. Here you go. So, what are you doing for spring break?
I'm going to Atlanta with my family.
Nice.
Here's your reward.
Sweet. Yes, we're doing it for the chocolate.
So what are your spring break plans?
I'm going to Florida for spring break at the RAs, actually. Doing a program where we're going to go look at the environmental wetlands down in Florida, so I'm going to do that in spring break. It should be a lot of fun.
Excellent.
And I'm also going to Florida. I'm going to Miami, and I'm going to sleep and crash over at my aunt's house.
Do you science or sleep?
I do science all year long.
Sweet.
Yes. Take the truffle.
Half of them are poison.
Sweet.
So what are you doing for spring break?
I also have the same plan as Mr. Ryan here, to go down to Florida to study the environment and learn how we can better affect our environment here with the wetlands in Arkansas.
Excellent.
Go out! Go pick it up, you're Larry.
You want to direct Justin to the bathroom?
No.
That was even worse than Pomfret.
Yeah. Oh, very good job.
Yeah. Worse than Pomfret.
Yeah, I didn't think it was possible.
Yeah.
But apparently, would people at this campus just don't know how to be interviewed? We
maybe
had to bribe
they just,
them.
Maybe they just caught him off guard. Maybe they just sensed that you got the chocolate out of the trash can.
The chocolate was the only way we got them to be on camera.
Yeah.
Well, like,
you know what? If we hadn't dug that out of the trash can.
When they smelled the trash smell emanating from the chocolate, maybe they were like, you know what? I don't have any plans.
If you're rich enough to afford chocolate, then maybe you can do the interview next time, Tina.
Okay, well, good.
Wow.
Yeah. If you got any cash line,
I will do that.
I like the package you made.
Yeah. Okay, well, good point. I accept that. No, really, that was good, guys. But so Zach was sitting here saying, dang it, I didn't get to say what I wanted to say about bikinis.
And he couldn't bring it up again
because he said, if I bring up bikinis for a third time, people will just think I'm obsessed. But he had a really interesting fact that he wanted to share.
I read an interesting story that I wanted to bring
right.
up.
Right, so I want to hear it again
I guess,
because it was so interesting.
Scientists did actual studies on, you know, brain waves, and they can tell which part of the brains mean you're thinking what. And whenever men see women in bikinis, the part of the brain that registers something as a tool, like an object to be used, lights up.
Headline news, breaking news.
Breaking news. Yeah. This is on like CNN. I mean, this is like breaking news.
It was the second top most popular story on
CNN.com. Scientists prove that bikinis objectify women, at least in men's minds.
Huh.
Yeah. I mean, even if it's not consciously, subconsciously, men are thinking, oh, sex object.
Yeah. So that is
that's
why,
just the mode you get in.
That is why I'm so glad that we made this about holistic fitness, not just physical fitness, because we are all about the entire person. We want boys to look at us as entire people. We want girls to
look at them. I want
them
to look past my receding
as
hairline.
Entire people. Yeah.
Like, I'm not just a
I've
sex object.
I've never even noticed it.
See?
Handsome.
See?
Handsome man.
Never even noticed the receding hairline. I tease him about it all the time. What does that say about me? But Molly also had some really interesting points.
I do. And these are things that are kind of seem, you know, basic that we all know. But sometimes you have to repeat it to remember it. Move more. Come on.
Move more.
Right.
That's easy, right? Move more.
I'm just going to do this. Keep talking.
No, that's really true.
Things. Take the stairs.
Fidgeters lose, just fidgeting, literally like tapping your toe. All of that
fidgeting.
Stuff, they are, it's been studied and
keep
they
going
really
on.
Are
you know,
skinny.
Just find daily ways to move your body. It doesn't have to be 45 minutes of cardio, you know, or kickboxing if you feel up to it. That's great. But it doesn't have to be. Another one, cut fat. Kind of a no-brainer. You know, avoid the fatty stuff.
I think everyone on this panel has a huge problem with overeating.
Avoid the fatty stuff like the pork, like the bacon, like the mayonnaise. But then also find healthy ways to substitute stuff in because you still want the condiments
tofu.
And stuff like that. So,
like
so find healthy ways.
Butter
Another one is reduce stress. Easier said than done. And it comes in many forms. So
don't care is the number one way to reduce stress.
Just not to care about things.
Stop not care.
Die inside a little bit. And
just
you'll
let it go. Let it free.
Did you just say die inside a little bit?
You just have to die inside a little bit.
And then, I just have to kill a part of myself. Yeah. And everything's cool.
You have to die in order to truly live.
Wow.
Adam, you're getting too deep.
Yeah.
I don't.
Profound.
It's the Bible. Let's steer this in the
right
direction.
Don't care, and you will
not
be stressed.
Speaking of steering, I'm going to segue into steering. Wear your
seatbelt. Over to you.
Wear
Wait,
your
seatbelt.
That's
the way to be healthy?
Yeah, overall. Come on, Tina.
Oh, add on overall. I'll believe you. I thought that, yeah, I really was thinking of those little belts that you wear that, like, zing you, you know, and you have to constantly be sucking in your abdomen. Right, yeah. And so I was thinking, wait, does a seatbelt have a similar effect when you're wearing a seatbelt? You would consciously suck in. Yes, I was really reading that much into that tip.
This is why we put Molly in charge of the tips.
It's very basic. Yeah. It says, this is funny. Statistics show that seatbelts add to longevity.
Longevity.
Right.
Okay. Live longer.
Imagine that.
Wow.
You also live longer if you go to church. I just read this in Time Magazine, so go to church.
And you live longer if you don't skydive.
Also, floss your teeth. It says recent studies make a direct connection to teeth flossers and longevity. And they say that it could possibly be because teeth flossers
are
apt to pay more attention to their overall health anyway. So
that does
that
make sense.
Start flossing your teeth and your whole life will follow suit and change. And lastly, we'll end with this. Keep a positive outlook on things. I know that's a lot easier said than done, but it really does help. If you're faced with crisis or stress... there's a definite connection between living healthfully and having a positive outlook. So those are just a few little things you can do.
They're good.
Your day.
Good tips. I like the last one. Right now I'm trying to eliminate the words annoyed and frustrated from my vocabulary.
That's impossible.
Yeah, I didn't realize how annoyed and frustrated
it's
I am.
Shift S7.
At the right time, you have to embrace that stuff. So, I mean, you can't always shove that down.
Yeah.
That's why I cry.
Right, because if you bottle it up, it's just going to...
And another way to reduce stress is to practice yoga. I know you practice yoga with, is it Andrea? Yes, yoga with Andrea in the mornings on UATD.
I do.
Yeah. But have you ever done yoga with me? You should stick around because that's what we're doing next.
She doesn't know yoga.
Yes, she
Maybe she does. I don't know. We'll find out.
Welcome back to AM Arkansas for the Yoga with Tina segment. You just saw an advertisement for Yoga with Andrea, but the advantage of doing yoga with us is that you don't have to wake up at 6:30. It's hard enough waking up at 8, as we all really know. This is my assistant, Molly. She's going to be helping us. So the first thing that I wanted to say was that it's super important to make sure that you're conscious of what you're wearing.
Yes.
The first thing that you should make sure of before you ever practice yoga is that you wear your most comfortable shoes. These boots are clearly the sort of boots in which I could run around a forest, climb trees. They're Peter Pan boots.
Right.
So wear your most comfortable shoes. The next step is to make sure you're wearing your most comfortable dress. And because there are lots of awkward poses in which your body is going every which way, a dress is a really good idea.
But I'm in my jeans.
Yeah, I know. Jeans are probably not the best
idea. I don't know a dress.
The best thing about yoga, you can make it work no matter what you're wearing.
That's the thing. You can, but I would recommend uncomfortable clothes. In general.
Well, I've got that down.
Right.
Uncomfortable clothes. Here
okay. So, the first thing that you need to do is just stand with your legs apart.
Toes pointing out. Here we go.
Sure.
All right. Do you have
We're making a tree. This is supposed to align your spiritual and your physical. And I feel aligned.
This is
All right,
terrible.
Now flat back. And up!
This is why Molly is my assistant. Because yoga makes me so happy. I just can't help but smile. I can't even talk.
Now,
because it just makes me so happy.
We're going to go to something that we like to call the warrior.
Woo!
So you're going to put your leg forward. Leg forward.
Yes.
And your back leg. If you can get a zoom in on my feet.
Yes.
It's really important.
The feet are super important.
Can see. Like this, boys, no, your foot is back.
Yes.
Like this. This is the warrior. Can you feel it?
See, and the boots really add to this.
Yeah,
that's
I
why
feel
it's
like
so
a warrior.
Can I roar?
That's
okay.
Why, yes.
Can I roar?
Oh, a roar is great.
So now you're going to lean into the warrior, boys. Lean into the warrior. Lean into the warrior. And then back.
And there's something kind of important about yoga that we failed to mention right now.
It burns
you're
the fat.
Supposed to breathe as you're doing it.
Look at this voice. You're doing great.
And the more you hold your breath, the better you do.
Yeah, you want it. Your tummy in.
If you pass out. If you pass out because you've been sucking in so long, that just means you're doing it right.
Look at this pose.
Look at Adam. That looks so great. Way to go.
Show your warrior face, Adam.
Yes. A warrior face.
That is fantastic.
Wow.
Okay, now
this is going so great. So,
what's
the next pose? The next pose
we would like to do, well, there's Downward Dog, of course.
I can't do Downward Dog right now.
Right,
it's
yeah,
we're a little uncomfortable.
But the gist of it is like the same kind of thing you do. You're dancing.
This is turning into a dance class.
Is this a booty dance or
yes.
is this yoga?
That's what you do Downward Dog. Okay, but also, because yoga is not the only thing you can do to stay in shape, we're going to do some other exercises like this. Oh, but don't stomp too hard because the microphones are in front of the stage.
Yes, and this is, you're really wanting to get your knees
right,
up.
Right, exactly.
You're burning the fat right there. You squeeze.
Right.
Squeeze. Keep squeezing.
Oh, and we're going to
practice. I really think I'm burning some fat right now.
Yeah, seriously.
That feels great.
So good. So, yeah, so we just want to throw things in like this every once in a while so that you get up and you get moving and you can practice almost. Yeah, don't you guys feel like
So you guys can learn from the masters.
Right.
Really.
And to show you that you can do it anywhere you are, any
no matter
time
what
of day,
you're wearing,
no matter what you're wearing.
No matter what you're wearing.
And we're going to have fun.
Yes.
It's a group
yes.
thing.
Yeah. There's also like, you know,
what's not
I remember.
To glow.
Yeah. Did you have you all ever watched Denise Austin?
No.
I really liked Denise Austin.
Actually, I watch it daily.
I just really liked it. One time she would have like a dribble, shoot. And I thought it was so funny and so silly. But you know,
she
isn't it amazing
working,
they
yeah.
make their whole livings doing this? I think we could definitely do it, Molly. I think you've got a future.
Thank you.
As an exercise.
I think you have a commercial as, I think you have a future as an infomercial girl.
As an infomercial.
Yeah.
You know what? That's
really
probably
good.
True. Yes.
That is something to aspire to.
Being
to be an infomercial.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what?
What?
You probably make a lot of money on those doing those infomercials.
Maybe, but I mean, think it. What do you want to do, little girl?
I want to be in infomercials.
Yeah, that's what I said when I was little. Thanks a lot, Zach. So anyway, now that he's dashed my dreams, we're gonna go to break. Yes,
we'll be right
back.
Because
he just dashed my dreams.
I'm always the jerk. I swear.
All right, we're back. We've got Tina and we got Adam up here. They're
going
to
be
doing their waltzing stuff.
Doing their thing.
Very interactive show this morning. How are you guys feeling up there?
Feeling good.
Good. They don't have mics feeling on, fantastic. So that's why they're acting like mimes, but it's great. So, we have the music. What are we going to do first? Adam, are you going to
Are you
going to
ask her how to dance, maybe? Tina
like
accepts. All right.
Okay, I don't really know anything about waltzing, Zach.
You know what? I've never waltzed in my life. I don't know why I'm narrating the waltz, in fact.
Yeah, I don't know why we're narrating the waltz. Maybe we should have been up there trying to waltz. All right, so it looks... I'll do a play-by-play. All right.
So Tina steps back. She steps to the side. She steps forward. She steps to the
she
side.
She goes!
She steps back.
Score!
She steps to the side. She steps forward. She steps to the side. Oh, Adam is following the twirl. Adam, that is like a master move.
I think the biggest mistake ever for a waltz is when the man steps on the woman's foot.
See, but I have big feet, you know?
No, there's no excuse.
No,
that means you need to go to dance classes and learn how to waltz.
Oh, perhaps. I mean, I like to think that I was born with rhythm, but maybe you're right.
So,
whoa!
Fumble.
Look at Adam. Did you see that? Did you see that move?
Fumble. Maybe if we can get the music up a little louder in the studio. Oops, I'm in camera here, sorry. That was so nice, you guys. Thank you so much for waltzing. It was
some hip-hop dances. Ready? Are you ready? Are you feeling it?
Guys, are we tossing to a package or? No. All right, stay with us. You're definitely still watching AM Arkansas, I promise. We'll be right back with more AM Arkansas.
All right.
Okay, welcome back to AIM Arkansas. I'm
now you know how to waltz.
A little bit of feedback on my mic. Okay,
my brain's getting a little bit of feedback.
Yes. We have a lot going on in our heads right now. So we decided that this is going to be just our completely candid segment. We're still kind of getting a feel for this stuff in case you haven't noticed, because the hardest thing to pull off is comedy. And we have a whole new respect for all those spoof shows, all the people who can just whip comedy out of nowhere and really make you laugh. We want to make you laugh. We also want to give you some things to think about. So we're going to keep working toward that every week.
Like what Adam just said.
Some of these things look better in our heads.
We're like, maybe we should have like informed the narrators how to waltz for a how to waltz segment.
Exactly.
Or maybe prepared like slides or something other than just shots of our torsos waltzing.
but we are all busy students, and we're doing the best that we can. Yeah. But we appreciate you sticking with us, and we're sure going to stick with it. It's
Assuming
just
going to
get better and better every week.
Stick with us.
Yes.
Yeah.
We're only getting better.
Yes.
Please don't. Like, if our rating drops any lower, we're going to be like in NHL territory, and we don't want to go there.
Oh, we don't want to be hockey.
No.
We do not want to be hockey.
Absolutely not.
All right.
So. Well, with that being said, we're just going to kind of put that stuff behind us. Maybe you did learn something, because Molly actually does know how to do yoga. Adam and I actually do know how to waltz, so if you picked up on anything at all, then we're really excited.
Or, you know, even if you just got a chuckle out of watching us be stupid.
Making idiots of ourselves.
That just contributes to your overall health.
Yes.
The laughter,
which is very important for your emotional health.
Yes.
I mean, you talked about crying.
Medicine.
But see, I'm not a crier. Like, I mean, I don't mean that in, like, a manly way, like, oh, I don't cry. I mean, I'm just not really crying.
You don't have tears. But you don't have tear ducts at all.
Yeah, for me, I let out emotion through laughing much more. Have you seen that Indian guru with the laugh?
I haven't.
The, like, laughing centers?
No.
No, really, it's like hundreds of people get together, and they get in circles, and they just, it starts off fake. He says,
hey, let's do that.
Fake it till you make it.
Let's do that right now, because I think that would be the perfect way to follow up
the
yoga and the waltz. Yeah.
I do have to say
a fake laughter segment.
We were just talking about how these segments sound better in our heads.
Yeah, let's say that experimental one for
so
next
week.
So
many times, though, and I know, especially as a kid, this was a lot, this would happen a lot more. My older sister and I were very close. We would just start laughing just together, and then for like 5 minutes, we could not stop. Our stomachs would hurt.
Yeah.
We would tense up. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
And you felt so good.
And it's basically scheduled groups that get together and they just start laughing, and then all of a sudden, like,
I'm
they're actually.
I'm going to start an RSO, which is a registered student organization, and it's going to be called the Laugh Factory.
The Laugh Factory.
Oh my gosh, that would be so fun. And you know what? Speaking of laughing, you're probably going to laugh when you see this, that what we're about to show you.
Whoa.
No. First off.
Yeah.
I thought we were going to laugh. It's not funny.
Well,
it's about Adam's Valentine's date.
Adam, how did your date go?
Well, which one?
Yeah. I mean, your Valentine's date, we gave it away to someone who called in.
Right.
Well, you know, a gentleman doesn't really, you know, get into details, but
It was good.
How good?
On a scale of one to
we're not going to talk about this.
How awesome was your date?
It was pretty much the Buzz Aldrin of dates. It wasn't the best ever, but it was, you know, she was just all
the Buzz.
What?
Good.
Why don't she we just love watch this package?
Adam, I just surprised you, Adam.
I didn't get home till like 6.
Really? That's funny. That's funny because
we're going to go to this package while they talk about it.
It's funny because I have some footage from your date.
What? How did you get footage from my date?
I spied on you. So let's check it out.
I get conquered.
Wow, that was a pretty good date,
wow,
Adam.
Wow, looks so exciting.
Hey.
She's a student here. That's pretty cool.
Hey.
Yeah, she's
like, you have a lot in common. You're both students here.
That was a nice line you used, by the way.
Yeah.
Thank you.
She was really pretty.
Yeah, she was beautiful. Look at her.
Well, what do you expect? You know, it's
but
me.
I did kind of notice. I thought, did it look like it looked like she had a ring?
Yeah,
on her
well,
finger.
A big she diamond loved me ring. So much that she like went out and bought her own engagement.
Really?
Ring.
Really? Somehow there. I wasn't feeling that chemistry. I don't.
It was just the untrained sometimes can't pick up.
Did,
how
did
to deal
she?
With women as
did
well.
She really I call? Did she really call in, or did you just like?
Well,
force
after the show,
force something. Did she? Oh, did you buy her free coffee?
I would never.
Did you bribe her with chocolate like you did our interviewees?
I would never.
That you got
sometimes
out of
sometimes I
to,
go on dates with guys I don't really like.
Wait, you didn't get the interviewees out of trash. You got the chocolate out of trash. Just to clarify.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right.
Well,
I just
it was,
said the interviewees.
You know, like I had so many offers for Valentine's Day, and I couldn't go through them all, and like, I, you know, you have, like, I had something to report in the next day, I think, and so I couldn't really go out to, like, Milan or, you know, Moscow. Right. Like, some of my friends wanted me to, and so just... Yeah. So
you had something the next day, but the date went to September.
You have lots of dates?
Oh, okay, okay. You know what? You know what? We believe you. We absolutely believe you. That date gave us such a window into your soul. Into you don't? I mean, yeah. I mean, we do.
Yes, I do.
Yeah, we believe you. So anyway, dating's a good way to address your fitness.
Yes, it is. It covers physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual.
And also, when you get a date, you feel so good about yourself. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
right?
That's why I'm always so.
It's kind of
that's
like
why you're always so happy.
That's why Adam is.
Because Adam is
kind of like affirmation.
So
like, hey, I know I'm hot stuff. I got a date.
Yeah, Molly knows how
Molly,
it is.
Yes. Molly knows how Adam works.
Some of us don't understand, but
you know what? Yeah.
I don't.
Third grade.
I don't understand. I wish that I did.
And it shouldn't stop after you've been dating for more than a year.
Yeah.
It shouldn't stop once you're married. You should still court and date the person you're married to and the person you've been dating for a year and a half.
So it just never ends.
It never ends.
You always have to be on your A game.
A never-ending source
don't
of health.
Relax.
And
you were on your A game in that video, by the way.
That was like my A super plus game.
Yeah. Speaking of A game, and I've noticed we've had to use speaking of as a transition quite frequently in this episode because we are so tangential that there's really no logical natural flow.
That's
right?
That every time you say tangent.
But yeah, exactly.
Tina's smart.
It comes from the word tangerine.
But really and truly, we have someone who is on her A game today, we think. You know, we just are sure because she's always on her A game.
She's awesome. Like, we're pretty lucky to have her on.
A musical guest.
Candy. More talent than us combined.
This will be a treat.
Candy Lee and
treat.
Yeah.
Candy.
So stick around through this break because when you come back, you're gonna hear some awesome music.
Yes.
Awesome.
So thanks for joining us, and like we said, stay tuned.
Sticking around, you're watching AM Arkansas, and we have a very special treat for you today. We have Candy Lee, who's only been here for about 6 months, and actually has only been playing music for about 6 months, but. In that time, she's gotten pretty amazing. So, Candy, I'm going to hand it over to you.
Thank you. This song is called Wake Up. Just to let you know, music is a really good way to get rid of stress, so I definitely recommend picking up a guitar one of these days. This is Wake Up. Where can you go when there's no place left that's free? Imaginary lines drawn in the sand keep us from where we want to be. And words written long ago, primitive ideas, keep us from moving on. Stuck in stagnant circles, round and round through time. When nothing is sacred, what can you keep? Paper, I owe you notes. Turn everything into commodities. And people sell their lives away to be able to survive. And nature is worth more when it's dead than when it is alive. We all just live. So wake up, brothers and sisters. We'll put our forefathers away. Wake up, brothers and sisters. Start a dawning of a new day. Wake up, brothers and sisters. will put our forefathers away. Wake up, brothers and sisters, start a dawning of a new day. A dawning of a new day. Too many times has injustice risen when we could have taken a stand. With our awareness, it's time to unite and bring others to understand that we can live free once again. So wake up, brothers and sisters, we'll put our forefathers away. Wake up, brothers and sisters, start a dawning of a new day. Wake up, brothers and sisters, we'll put our forefathers away. Wake up, brothers and sisters, start a dawning of a new day. A dawning of a new day.
And that was simply amazing.
Thank you.
Like I said, real talent. Thank you, Candy, for coming on and making this show worth watching.
Thank you very much. My pleasure.
You can find you on your MySpace.
MySpace.com/ It's Candy Long's Music. Long is my last name. Lee is my middle name. So it's Candy Long's Music.
Candy Long's Music. All right. MySpace.com. And we'll see you guys right after break.
No, we won't.
I'm Judy Shep.
That was amazing.
Thank you very much.
That was fantastic.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Yes. It was so good. Molly and I were just standing in the back saying
gave
that.
Gave us chills.
Yes. Chills and
so almost wonderful.
So what kind of style of music do you play? Who are some of your influences?
I'd say my biggest influences are definitely Fiona Apple, Devendra Banhart. Not a lot of people have heard of him, but he's really good. He does a lot of folk music. I would say I do kind of like a folk/jazz kind of style myself.
It works.
And you were saying that you have a demo out right now.
I do. I have a 9-song demo. I recorded it at home on my my Mac computer in GarageBand. It turned out all right, but I just bought a couple of good mics, so I'm going to be re-recording those songs and adding a couple more. Hopefully the full length will be out by summer.
Fantastic. Now, Candy, tell us and everybody where we could find out more about you.
Definitely the MySpace page.
Is it just Candy Lee?
Candy Long's Music.
Candy Long's Music.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Candy
Long's, it's a little confusing. Yeah.
We'll put the link up on our Facebook.
Yeah.
So check
out. You can definitely go on there. I think you can download some tracks, but you can definitely listen to the tracks on there as well.
Great.
Well, and also, I don't know if we said it, but she writes all of her own music, so the song that you heard, she wrote. So beautiful talent. And she said before she played, music is a great stress reliever, and in so many ways is about so much more than just the music. I mean, it does engage your mind and your spirit and so much. Mm-hmm. So we just really appreciate you coming on the show.
Yeah, that was a treat for us. You know, I really enjoyed that.
Yeah, and we would love, if you are up to it, if you would play us off the show, because we just enjoyed listening to you so much. We'd love to hear more.
I surely will.
Thank you. And we will see you.
What are you going to play for us?
This song is called Sweet Music.
Sweet Music.
So thank you so much
Very
for being
appropriate.
Here, and thank you guys for watching. We'll be back next week at the same time.
So, guys, we're going to let Candy take it away.
We're going to enjoy this right now.